Breaking overnight, the man accused in the string of Pine Hill shootings that took the lives of three people, including a 9-year-old girl and a Spectrum News 13 reporter, now will be facing a new set of charges.
The charges were posted to the Orange County Jail's website just hours ago. West 2's Bob Hazen joins us live now from the jail. And Bob, Keith Moses now faces 5 additional charges.
Yeah, that's right. And that includes 2 new murder charges for the deaths of little Tiana Major and for reporter Dylan Lyons. Now, 19-year-old Keith Moses was already being held on no bond right here at the jail for the first murder of Natasha Augustine. Investigators say that Moses killed her first before then shooting the Spectrum News 13 crew and Tiana and her mother inside their house last week. The News 13 photographer and Tiana's mom did survive, and Moses is facing 2 new counts of attempted murder in their cases, plus a burglary charge. The sheriff has said that this shooting spree was random, that Moses didn't seem to have any reason for the attacks, and jail records show those new charges were filed overnight. But at this point, we don't have the court records to go along with them, so we are still working to get information about what investigators have uncovered since the shooting. Now, Moses should also be scheduled to appear in front of a judge for the first time on these new charges later on today. The last time when he was first arrested, he did not appear in front of a judge because of mental health reasons. His lawyer has filed a plea of not guilty. Reporting live at the Orange County Jail, Bob Hazen, West 2 News.
A local gymnastics company is hosting a fundraiser in honor of 9-year-old Tiana Major. Tiana was a competitive gymnast with dozens of medals already under her belt. She practiced 3 times a week but never made it to last Wednesday's practice. Her coach at Orlando Metro Gymnastics says that she had a fighting spirit until the end.
Her dad said, "You'd been proud of her. She fought. She fought for her life in the ambulance, and she fought for her life on the operating room table. And she was a fighter," because I always told her dad, "She's a fighter. She's a warrior in competition. She just wanted to be the best she could be out there."
An open gym fundraiser will be held this Friday at all 4 of Orlando Metro Gymnastics locations. We are told that all of the money will go to Tiana's family.